In today's rapidly changing digital marketplace, providing IT workforce solutions to help in-house resources tackle what's next has become crucial. From staffing consultation to finding top IT professionals, optimizing IT contract labor to searching job opportunities and more, much more, today's enterprise must focus on comprehensive IT specialization, on-site resource planning and service, as well as local market focus and knowledge. Sound simple? Not so fast. Getting it right is complex, and more often than not, the competitive difference between mere survival and market dominance. The reality is, you must have the best-fitting job candidates first time, every time. Greetings, everyone. It's Friday, October 3rd, 2014, and this is Tech Talk with Technology Association of Georgia President Tino Mantella. I'm your guest host, Frank Baia. Up to the Tech Talk, we meet the chairman of the board and owner of MDI Group, Ella Koscik. Ella oversees the nationally recognized company, which has now grown to become a premier Atlanta-based IT staffing solutions firm. And as board chair and owner, she is dedicated to ensuring the profitability of a $50 million company with 120 clients nationwide, 7 offices, 60 internal employees, and hundreds of technology consultants. Ella was named Top 25 Powerful Woman to Watch by Atlanta Woman Magazine and awarded the 2010 Trailblazer of the Year by the Greater Women's Business Council of Georgia and the Carolinas for entrepreneurial success and innovation. With a 20-year leadership focus on integrity, entrepreneurship, and philanthropy, she is a business strategist with a practical vision, quick to take the best advantage of industry trends while understanding the need for flexibility when market forces dictate redirection. It's a Tech Talk focus on what's next in IT staffing solutions and company competitiveness in the digital economy in the face of challenging business objectives. It's all about the best information technology staffing services and contingent workforce solutions to support in-house resources as they tackle what's next as we Tech Talk with the MDI Group owner and chairman of the board, Ella Koscik. This edition of Tech Talk is brought to you by GlobalSpeak.com, new media consultants, corporate video and audio communications, video and audio production and distribution, live and virtual event production. Tag TV and Tag Radio is a service of GlobalSpeak.com, creatively delivering powerful marketing, video, and audio solutions. Ella, welcome to Tech Talk.
Hi.
Well, obviously, it's a great opportunity to take a look at a little bit of the past and certainly what's going on today, but also a jump into the future. Let's start out by telling some of our members about MDI and maybe your tenure at the organization.
Well, hi, Frank. Thank you for asking. MDI and myself, MDI, we provide a variety of staffing solutions that give local IT executives the resources needed to tackle technology projects and achieve business objectives. We help companies that are struggling to find the best fit IT talent. In today's market, that's not an easy task. Essentially, we partner with them to understand their current IT initiatives and understand their company culture so that we can identify the best fit professionals. So, you know, it's a pretty competitive platform that we compete on.
Sure.
And that we've been competing for over 20 years.
Well, I think probably one of the best things going is the fact that the time that you've been invested allows you a sense of context so that you not only understand exactly what the situation is right at the moment, but probably a little bit even deeper than some of the IT officials that are in the companies that might just kind of be coming to it as a fresh or a new problem.
Exactly, exactly. And, you know, it's funny, over the last 20 years, I've seen a lot of things that have impacted, you know, the business, and especially, you know, when you look at the economy. You know, for example, you have Y2K, the dot-com era. You know, today, you know, you have the need for the Java developers, mobile apps, and things that you just wouldn't have expected. All of these have impacted us, and the need for our IT talent is just at a high.
Well, I remember Jobs saying something like, customers don't know what they need until they see it. I think it's a case now where we're talking about disruptive technology so much that it isn't a disruption anymore. It's really technology and the problems that some of your enterprise tech officials have to face every day. It's a real challenge to keep up with what's the latest and to, as you point out, measure the ability and the value of a particular prospect as far as an employee is concerned.
Exactly, and you know, and I agree. You know, I can talk and help hopefully the audience that's listening about the business side of the company that I've worked with for over 20 years, and you know how it impacts and how IT impacts small companies, mid-sized companies, and even large organizations from an IT staffing perspective and a technology perspective. So hopefully some of the things and lessons I've learned over the last 20 years will help some of the listeners today.
Well, I think that's exactly our audience. The TAG members face these challenges every day. It's either a case where it's a hot pocket and there's so many potential prospects that you're able to make a selection, but more likely than not, it's the opposite, and that is you've got opportunities to grow, but you really can't find the proper kind of candidates to be able to make those contributions to remain competitive. Let's talk, you mentioned about lessons. Let's talk a little bit about that. Maybe kind of narrow it down, but give us, say, the top three lessons you've learned along the way and what other companies are looking that they can do, especially from outside sourcing and staffing, but maybe even go into some of the scale and what they can learn from that.
Well, if I had to mention top three lessons, you have to know what you're good at. Early on, when you're starting a company and working at a company, you have to know what you're good at, and you have to hire for what you're not. One of the key success factors that MDI has experienced is the second to that is strategy. And not second to that, I don't want to say that it's second because our strategy has always been number one, but it's strategy, and execution. And it's like the saying, you know, you can have an A strategy, but if your execution lacks, then you're going to fail. But we hold execution to our strategy very important, and that alignment that's created through the organization because of that execution has really helped us become successful. And then I think the third lesson, after running MDI and being there for over 20 years, it really will probably go to what I've been weak at. And as I've said earlier, hiring better and hiring great people and you know, really understanding what that is over the years, my biggest weakness has always been on the financial side of the business, and I've had to really step that up and understand what that knowledge is to the business and how that impacts the business going forward. So I think, you know, hopefully that brings some clarity to the lessons learned.
Well, I think, you know, the irony of there is some personality or cultural quirks that kind of fall into play. I think most entrepreneurs, unfortunately, maybe in some cases, like with incubators, they're almost forced to gain a lot of disciplines where they really just don't have the capability. And in doing it, like you were talking about, say, with finance, they dilute their core and don't realize that it is really about team. It's about putting together the right kind of players to complement rather than replicate something that you're really good at doing.
Exactly. You know, it's funny. Our saying at MDI is that early on, we don't need a bunch of Ellas running around.
Yeah,
I think that
exactly.
Would have caused a great bit of chaos. So, you know, we hire individuals that have their own set of strengths, and we let them excel at that. So, yes.
Well, and I think that model fits the situation as you're relating to some of your clients in terms of they really don't need to try to find the perfect solution when they can come to you, and you can analyze it and find it either, I'm assuming, both on a temporary and a permanent basis.
Exactly. I mean, we do work more on the contingent labor side, but in order to do that, and what model we have found to be most successful is where we can work intimately with our clients, understand what their pain is and where they're really struggling, and align solutions with that. Because there really aren't two clients or three clients or four that are the same. You know, each client has their own set of struggles, their own set of initiatives, and we need to be respectful of that and align our solution around what they're looking for around talent.
Well, and not to dilute the contribution, but I'm going to guess that, you know, in many cases on Tech Talk, we scan all of the different sectors. So every vertical that you can imagine has something to do with technology in one way or another. And we often say everything's the same, only different. You know, the idea of high-speed connectivity and cloud computing and mobile devices and the impact of bring your own device and almost all the commonality of the technology aspects in a way are the same, but it's that packaging, design, it's that understanding of the strategic. It's and I would think that one of the benefits that you enjoy at MDI is the ability to deal in best practices. I mean, to learn from the things that you do and learn to how you did them well and be able to replicate them so that your percentages in terms of hitting that bullseye gets just better and better and better with each particular project.
Absolutely. You know, we've been meeting with one client that really is struggling with, for example, their onboarding process. And they're growing, they're expanding, they're hitting on all cylinders, but yet because they're really suffering as far as their turnover. So we've been really able to go in there, and they've shared their concerns with us, and they've shared their models with us. And because they've been able to do that, we've really been able to go in there and work as a partner to help identify what the proper solution is. So it's those that type of client where we really gauge the greatest amount of success.
Well, and adulation. I mean, it's always great not only to know you're doing something financially rewarding, but obviously doing something where you're really making a difference. Now, I know that based on some of the research that we've done, that you've successfully divested yourself of two divisions of the company, MDI Medical and MDI Finance. What have you learned about these experiences, and what can you share with some of our listeners?
Well, let me start by saying I learned many. I think it's important to break it down into two parts. The sale of each of those divisions and what was learned through both of that process, and then the reasons why the decision was made, I think would help. I think it's important for a couple reasons. The medical division and the finance and accounting division both were started within a couple years of each other. Their revenues of each were in excess of about between 9 and 11 million. Under 5 years, that's pretty good. Very profitable revenue as well. So a lot of companies would look at that and say, why would you, you know, not continue to grow that type of success?
I would say that's an understatement, but go ahead.
However, the reasons for starting those staffing divisions were outside our core. And if you look at the date in which we started those, is right after, right in the early, about 2002, 2003, right when everyone was talking around diversification. After Y2K, a lot of things happened. Everyone felt that if you were to diversify your business, you would be safeguarding around the future. Well, one of the lessons that I learned is that diversification is good. However, you need to stay true to your core. You need to, and I think that brings a very clear message around what we learned today, around our lessons learned. We're a highly focused organization that is diversified, but within our core expertise, which is technology. So through, you know, and we learned that through our strategic planning. And through that strategic planning process, we've learned to stay, you know, very, very focused. So on the other side of that, what I learned, you know, I didn't really, you know, I've never set up a company to sell it. So not ever, you know, having the aspirations of selling or sold a business before, it was all new to me. So I learned terms, words, and now have an understanding of, you know, an elementary degree of M&A that I never signed up for. But with that being said, like most things in my life, I just led with my heart. And I looked at this as a need to find a home for the employees and the consultants and divisions that worked at MDI, because they were great people. And
good people do the right thing. You know, as I'm listening to you, I'm thinking of the commercial with the guys on the yacht that says that if I really had invested in 40 words or less, I'd have the yacht. So as you were telling me you were selling off these companies, I'm thinking surely poor Ella's had days when she regretted the fact that she let those companies go. But yet, on the other hand, what are we talking about now? $50 million company with 120 clients nationwide, 7 offices, 60 internal employees, and hundreds of technology workforce consultants. I think you made the right decision.
Well, thank you. I appreciate that. I mean, I do believe that a highly focused organization at the end of the day was the right thing to do. And I'm proud to say that both acquisitions or divestitures have gone very well. And That doesn't happen very often. So it's worked out both for MDI Group today and the Finance and Accounting Division as well as the Medical Division.
Well, I think in a lot of technology companies, they look for proof of concept. I think you're living proof of the concepts that you express. So let's talk a little bit about the internal, though, in terms of the structure. Obviously, a lot of companies struggle with determining the right time to establish a board of directors, but how does a company determine when the time is right? And what's the hardest part of establishing, say, for example, in your case, the MDI board?
You know, I actually took a, I'll be honest, I took a shot at this several years ago, and I failed. And I think that, in all honesty, most people are going to learn from people's failures than their successes. So I took a shot at that probably 10 years ago. I brought in a couple people, and I didn't have the knowledge or understanding to try to execute. So I went back at it, you know, about 2 years ago, because I always felt that having mentors and people that really could help you take an honest look at your business, because you're in it day to day. You can't really look at things like somebody else can, and the individuals that I have on the board, they have such a different perspective that is so insightful. So, you know, knowing that, you know, I took a shot and I failed, that it shouldn't stop you from trying again. You got to look and see what that mistake was. But, you know, it's hard. This time around, I did more research. I talked with a number of different people, did a lot of interviews with consultants and different things. But in the end, I realized that the success of this board was going to come down to my willingness to commit to it. So I think that's what it really comes down to, is that you, as the leader, need to really demand that you're going to make this work, and it's on you to do it. So I believe in mentors. It started early on. One of my early mentors taught me that executive level alignment is very important in growing your organization. He also taught me that working with a CEO who was a CEO of a billion-dollar company, there's a lot of responsibility that comes with that. So I had to be very respectful with his time. So I do the same, and I have the same philosophy with my board. You know, I'm very respectful, very mindful of their time and what they give, the information and support that they give MDI as well.
Well, I'm thinking in terms of they always talk about computer years being like dog years or something, you know, and there isn't just 1 year, and it's, you know, the normal time that we measure it by, but it's 7 or 10 years, and the wisdoms that you're expressing obviously are one that would have come from, if you believed in being here before. It sounds, you sound too wise to have only been here once. Let's talk a little bit about giving back. We're quickly running out of time, Ella, but in addition to leading MDI, you obviously have a pretty strong commitment to philanthropic efforts. Talk a little bit about the Ella Marie Foundation, and what's the goal of the foundation, and how do you help?
Oh, I appreciate you asking. It's very near and dear to my heart. It's one of the things I'm most proud of. 20 years ago, actually, it probably sparked, you know, the interest in. There was only five of us in the office, and we chose a fundraising charity for children. And since then, all of the locations, all seven locations in corporate, every quarter choose a charity in their communities to support. And from that, you know, it's just very well aligned with MDI. And about 10 years ago, I decided, you know, I really need to have a foundation that can, you know, its mission is very direct. It's to make a difference in the lives of women and children in today's world. So it's simple, but I feel like it's not a responsibility, but to me it's an opportunity that I've been given to give back. And it's something I'm very passionate about and I really enjoy.
Well, I can hear it in your voice, and I think it comes across not only in the philanthropic efforts, but your commitment to your clients and your desire to, perfection is one of those lofty things that are difficult to reach, but I got a feeling you're close to it and aren't going to give up until you get there. Well, we quickly ran out of time, Ella, but a very impressive conversation. What a great opportunity to share some thoughts and to hear some of your experiences, and congratulations on the huge success, tough decisions in some cases that obviously turned out to be really great. But thank you so much for taking time out of your busy schedule to join us for a few minutes today on Tech Talk.
Thank you, Frank. I really enjoyed it, and I enjoyed talking with you. And I wish you all the success as well.